All right, truck wars. This is interesting. I found this fascinating. First and foremost, full disclosure, I'm kind of excited. I want to see what Tesla's going to have with their Cybertruck comes out this year. Let's see, but he's kind of anticipating that. This past week, Ford actually signed a deal with Tesla. It seems like all these EV manufacturers are coming to some sort of meeting of the minds when it comes to standardizing electric chargers for the cars, and they're going to be able to go to the Tesla chargers. But it was interesting. You had the CEO of Ford, Jim Farley, basically saying that Tesla's Cybertruck is a vehicle for Silicon Valley people, while his company's F-115 Lightning electric truck is for real people who do real work. The reality is America loves an underdog, and we are the market leader for EV trucks and vans, and we know those customers better than anyone. If he wants to design a Cybertruck for Silicon Valley people, fine. And he was asked, you know, whether or not Tesla's electric truck would eat into Ford's customers. Musk has touted the Cybertruck, expected to release by the end of this year, as better utility than a truck with more performance than a sports car. There's going to be two Cybertrucks available. One's 60 grand that's got two motors. Another one is 70 grand with three motors. Farley said that it's a cool high-end product that looks good in front of a hotel. I don't make trucks like that. I make trucks for real people who do real work, and that's a different kind of truck. Okay. Ford F-150. Lightning. Came out last year, last spring, April 22. It's got models that range from $60,000 to $100,000. $100,000. Do you think many, you know, you're gonna do your, you know, like a rock? Was that Chevy or was that Ford with the Bob Seger song there? I don't see it. I just don't. I don't see someone spending $100,000 on a work vehicle. That's just me. Anyone? Let's look at sales. The Ford Lightning F-150. 4,300 units sold in the first quarter this year. They were projecting 6,300. Whereas Ford's F-150 gas-powered line sold 170,000 during the same period. So stop telling me that, you know, your truck here is for working people. Why wouldn't they get it? 170,000 F-150. We mentioned that. That is a number one car for millionaires here in this country, the Ford F-150 combustion engine. Anyway, Ford's quarterly revenue, $41.5 billion. They did fine. But again, you think about how is Ford making its money? It's not on EVs, it's on combustion engine vehicles. The idea that there's going to be some sort of change anytime soon with that, you're crazy. We talked about that here on the program, the $2 billion that General Motors is now investing in combustion engine factories. They're going to be all electric by 2035? I don't think so. I don't see it happening. Again, you know, I don't know. I don't know how popular Tesla's Cybertruck is going to be. I've mentioned here on the program, when I travel and I got to get myself a rent-a-car, I hate scrambling on the way back to the airport, trying to, you know, find a gas station that you're going to overcharge near the airport. So I've been getting electric vehicles, but I do admit that there are times, and I'm running low on electricity. Running low on electricity, and I got to try to find a charging station. I actually was down there. I downloaded the app, needed to charge my Tesla Model 3 that I was renting. And it was the app was ChargePoint. And they had it at the hotel. They had a garage there. I could charge there, download the app. I did it. I plugged the thing in. And I was blown away. Blown away. The ChargePoint charger into the Tesla, it told me, you know, full charge, 18 hours. What? I mean, you really, things that we become accustomed to in life that are just there, like, hey, geez, there's a gas station everywhere. I can fill up on my car. I can drive all across the country. I don't have to worry about it. With electric vehicles, you got to worry about it. I pulled into Tampa Airport about 10% left in a charge on the Tesla 3, and I had agita. Again, issues that have yet to be worked out. WatchDog on Wall Street.com.